two, one, two, three, four. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
John Fix and I were messing around in the shop, and we came across some old tools that needed some work. So today we're going to restore these nice International Harvester tools. Let's get down to the shop and check it out.
Here are two International Harvester wrenches from my collection. This first one, I guess, was one of the first wrenches I ever found. And I didn't do much to it because I really didn't know much what I was doing then. And, all I did was wire brushed it and got the rust off and put a coat of lacquer on it to protect it, which I really wouldn't do today. Look at the finish on here. It's just pitted terribly. Rough ridge around all around here. I guess I did flatten out, kind of tried to flatten out this jaw, but really in bad shape. So my goal today is to take this and get it up to today's standard, which are a lot better than they were then. They noticed this was patented in September 7th, 1897, so quite an old wrench. Over about 26 years old. This other wrench, I had to look for a while to find that logo and realize that was International Harvester. It's on there, and I think it shows up on here too somewhere. As I got to looking at the wrench. Well, I had to do a lot of looking to find it. There it is. And now it just says a number 2. I don't have a clue what that's all about. And it does say IE here. And there's the other International Harvester logo down here. IE, I don't know. This says 2E. So IE and 2E, have no clue why that's on there. But you can see the condition of this one, the casting mark or forging mark all the way around, just rough finish on it. So we're going to get these wrenches looking really nice, try to get them, you know, restored back to what original condition would have been. And we'll be back to show you what we're doing. Okay, the teardown is completed on these two wrenches. This one was fairly simple. Just unscrew this adjustment nut all the way and eventually got this piece loose. This one was a lot more difficult. I had to really put a lot of muscle on it to get this nut off of this rusted piece, and of course I managed along the way to, it was already scarred pretty bad, but even got it a lot worse. I tried to grip it very carefully each turn with the wrench so it wouldn't slip, but we'll have to do some repair on this to get this restored right. But once we get it all cleaned up, I'm sure it'll function a lot better. And now we can get to all the different parts on the wrench to get everything wire brush cleaned up, sanded, and ready for a final finish. Okay, here's our progress on these International Harvester wrenches. We wire brushed them. Of course, you can really see the flaws now once you take that top coating of rust and patina off of it there. Lots of nicks and marks and flaws, casting marks, etc., to be taken care of. There's a little adjustment nut we've cleaned up a bunch. I'm going to do a little bit more work on it because with this other wrench, This one was just utterly miserable shape. So I've spent a good few hours on this already, sanding down in every one of these grooves, sanding the top ridge. It's still got a little roughness in here, but it's a huge improvement over where it was. I think I want to get it a little better before I install it on the wrench here. There's still a lot of little marks down in here, but I've been using a little small round file on it here down in each one of these grooves over and over and over again. It just don't, you know, the pitting is deep in the grooves too. Oh, wow. I'll be careful of that. That's got a sharp point. Anyway, the wire brushing is done. So we know we got to do a lot of work still on these because it's just a lot of roughness on them. I want to get them taken down smooth and finish them out so I can see what kind of finish I want to put on them. So I'll get to doing some sanding now. Remember how these wrenches looked when I started? I spent a lot of time, a really lot, long time, searching for history on International Harvester tools. And I found a lot of fixed wrenches, non-adjustable fixed wrenches, found loads of them, but only found a couple of the adjustable type monkey wrenches, I'll call them. And what I did find was this wrench with the loop handle on it. Then I found this wrench also with a little different part that extended and where the upper jaw was all enclosed in there. But it was basically the same wrench, the same mechanism. This wrench I saw just in this style. So, evidently they didn't make a lot of adjustable wrenches. But, first of all, the one up top here. I'll show you what I did to finish it out. And basically I went with just a brushed finish on it, enough to get all of those rough edges sanded down and smoothed. I did a lot of wire brushing. First, I wire brushed it on the bench grinder. Then I took it outside and used my cup wheel, which is a real coarse wheel with my grinder on it. And then I followed that up with a finer cup wheel and really gave it a good thorough working over with the wire brush before I came back and went with my sander to try to get it smoothed out. But I did make a goof here. You can still see the International Harvester logo, but I made a mistake on it. I was showing somebody what I was doing with my angle grinder and the flap disc, and when I was busy talking and running my mouth, and I wasn't paying attention enough to what I was doing here, and I wiped over that and took a flattened it out some, but it's still on there, and you can tell what it is. It's just a dumb mistake. The other logo, International Harvester logo, is showing well on this side. Actually, it goes like this, which is IH with the big C around it. I also did notice on this wrench it had an IE stamped on it. Have no clue what that means unless it was somebody's initials. But if you go over here, the wrench is marked 2E. And 2E is a correct model number for this wrench, 2E. So I don't know what 1E has to do with it. It must be something else. And this little dial in here, adjustment knob, was in the was really tight and hard to work, but I was able to get it off and get this cleaned up a lot. It looks a lot better now. And decided to leave it in the natural finish there. Looks really good compared to where we started. The second wrench was really dark all over it. It was one that I had lightly brushed and then put a coat of lacquer on when I got it, which just, it looked crummy, but that was one of the first tools I ever did, so I didn't know what I was doing then. I think I got a little better handle on it now. But here's how we finished this ranch out. And this turned out really nice. I really like this ranch. Very unusual design on it. I did do the brush type finish on here too, all the way around. This side turned out pretty good. This side had a lot of heavy pits in them, as you can see here. Look at that. Really deep. The ones you can put a probe down into, and it keeps on going and keeps on going. So I couldn't take those out without just really taking off a ton of material. If you can see it on this side here, you can see where it's even a little dented in where I was working on this one. I took some material out, so I decided to stop where I was. It's just part of those character lines, I call them. Character marks. What was really tough on this ranch was getting down in these areas here that were really tight. And again, did the wire brush on with my bench grinder, then went outside with the coarse and then a fine cup wheel with the angle grinder, and was able to really get down in here and get that area cleaned up. So you can see the writing quite well on it now. International Harvester patent September 7th, 97, which is 1897. Quite an old wrench. 125 years. This knob here was a disaster. It was really bad when I got it, and I had to work really hard turning it to get this tool all the way apart, and in doing so, I really damaged it even more. But as you can see now, I spent a lot of time with the small file getting down in each one of these grooves. I spent hours just on this knob, but I knew it had to look nice for the tool to look nice, and wanted to get back to almost the way it came. Couldn't get it all the way done, but got it in pretty good shape. This side, again, you can see some evidence of some of the pitting. I got a good bit out, but it's got some parts here that wouldn't clean up very well. But the tool overall looks good. Unusual loop handle design. You know, lots of areas to clean up on here. Heavy. A lot of pitting on it and a lot of casting marks or forging marks, whatever they were. So we got it looking good. There's a little comparison to the original, way I got it, the way it looks now. And I think I'm happy with the tools the way they came out. I think they look nice. They'll be nice. This will be nice. These will be nice to display if I ever find any room. I've reworked and reworked my display where it's just every corner is full. And of course, when I took them and redid the whole display by tool brand, it takes up more room that way, but it looks a lot neater. So we'll find a place for them sooner or later, because International Harvester, interesting wrenches. There weren't many made. I think you see a fair amount of them around, especially this type. Well, actually, I've seen them both for sale. Don't seem to be going for much in the way of price. So there's probably not a lot of value here. But interesting wrench to have and an interesting piece of history. Thank you for watching my video.